In this tutorial, I'll show you how to create particles from live text in After Effects. The fascination with particles is endless, as they form the very essence of our being. Yet the native particles effect in After Effects often leave much to be desired in terms of versatility and visual flair. The quest at hand was to try and unlock the potential of creating vibrant emitting particles originating directly from live text, utilizing nothing but the software's built-in capabilities. Stay with me through this journey, and I will unveil an intriguing technique to transform text into sand-like effect using the same approach. What's more, for those eager to incorporate this magic into their project, the project files are available to download at a nominal fee. This is not just a tutorial, it's an invitation to enhance your creative toolkit and bring your digital compositions to life. So I'm working in this 7-second square composition, but you can use any comp size and length you want. I also created a background using a shape layer with a radial gradient with these colors. Now let's start by creating the text. So I'll make sure nothing is selected, and I'll double click on the text icon to create a text object in the middle of the screen. I'll type the text that I want to create. In this case, it is the Rocket Man. It will make sense in a moment, I promise. And then I'll return to the selection tool. I'll select this text and I'm going to change the font here to Bebas Noia. I'm going to choose the bold weight. This is a font that you can sync from Adobe Font. I'll make sure it is centered. I'm also going to change the type size to 300, and I'll change the leading to 220, and then I'll drag it so it will be more or less in the center of the screen. I'll change the fill color to white, but in this case, I'm actually going to switch it off and start with a stroke color. So this one wants to be white, and I'll change it to 2 pixels. I'm also going to go to the rotation in the properties panel and change it to 15 degrees, and then I'll place it somewhere over here. And lastly, I'll add the bulge effect just to blow up this text and create something more interesting. So the horizontal and vertical radius, in my case, are going to be 600. And of course, I can move this center point so it will look nice and round like this. Then I'll add the 4-color gradient effect, and I'll select different colors for color 1 and color 2. So I'll click on color 1. This one will be an orange color. And for color 2, I'll take it to the cyan area. And of course, you can choose whatever colors you like, but for me, this is what I'll go with. Then I'll collapse those 2 effects, and I'm also going to add the glow effect. Now, to make the most out of the glow, I'll return back to the project panel. I'll option click twice on this little button to convert the project to 32 bit per channel. And then I will start to lower the threshold to, let's say, 10, and I'll take the radius to 15. And this is going to give us a really nice and vivid glow. Just for the sake of comparison, if I'll option click again, this is the 8-bit per channel result, and this is the 32, much more vivid and nice. And now it's time to add the particles. So I'll return back to the timeline, press Command Y to create a new solid. I'll name it Text Particles. The color doesn't matter, but I will select black, make sure it is set to the comp size, and click OK. And then to this solid layer, I'll add the CC composite effect, and I'm going to ask it to reference the text layer. I'm also going to tell it to use its effects and masks. So we're going to basically create another duplicate based on whatever we are going to use over here. So no need for pre-comping. This is going to be our only composition. I'm going to change the transfer mode to copy, and I'll take out the RGB only, basically recreating whatever we have underneath. And then I'll switch off the visibility for the text. And this is going to be our base layer for the particles. So I'll go now to the effect menu. This time, just to show you, under the simulation category, I'll select the CC Particle Systems 2. Now, this guy has a very unique feature under the particle, and this is the secret ingredient for our tutorial. I'll make sure you can read it. It says source alpha inheritance. By checking this, the particles that we're going to create are going to be driven from the alpha channel of the layer. And since we are referencing the text, this is going to help us to create particles which are emitting from the text layer. I'll start by changing the color map to origin constant, and this is going to sample the colors from the layer, in our case, the four color gradient. I'm also going to change the transfer mode to add, and because we are here in this section, let's also change the particle type to star. You can go with whatever you like, but for my example, I'll change the birth size and depth size to 0.05. I'll change the size variation to 100. The opacity map, I'll switch it to fade in and out, and I'll change the maximum opacity to 100%. Now, it doesn't look like much at this stage because we need to go back to the producer as well as probably create more particles. So for the birth rate, I'll select 200. And then for the radius X and Y, I'll set it to 100. So now it looks like this. Again, nothing to write home about, but we can see that actually it is emitting from the text. To make it more apparent, I'll open up the physics, and first I'll change the velocity to 0. Next, I'm also going to change the gravity to 0. So the particles are basically going to stay at the same place. They're not going to move anywhere. And this is a look that you can just use if you want to, as is. However, I'm going to change the velocity to a very small number. Let's try 0.05 and see how this works. We can actually select it and type different numbers while After Effects is caching those frames. I think I'm going to go with 0.08 in this case, because I do want a bit of separation here. And this means that I can now bring back the original layer, and those particles are going to emit from this layer. Now, to create some sort of a transition, I'll go to 3 seconds over here, select the original text, hold down Option, this will be Alt and Shift on the Windows side, and press T to show the opacity as well as create a keyframe for it. And then I'll go to 1 second and change the opacity to 0. I'll select both keyframes by pressing on the world opacity. Press F9 to easy ease. Visit the graph editor. Select the first point here and just make sure I'm creating a nice smooth ease in, so the text is going to fade in nicely like this. Now again, I do want to emphasize this is still based on a live text. So if I'll pause the playback and I'll double click to select the text layer, this is going to highlight whatever I have over here, and I'll type something else like I'm still standing, which is not true because I'm sitting, but you know, you got the joke. It's still going to work. If I want to change the colors, I can return back to the text, open up the four color gradient, and choose different colors. By the way, a cool way to do it is to double click on the color, which is going to reveal itself in the timeline, and then I can click and drag to the right or to the left to scrub the hue value. So maybe something like this, totally up to you. Now, just to show you something in context, I'm going to open up the Rocketman comp that I have over here, which is basically using the same thing that I just showed you. I'll press spacebar to preview it. And I'm also going to maximize the frame by pressing on the tilde key. And this comp is using the advanced 3D renderer because I've added this 3D rocket model and animating it using a null object, which is also controlling the smoke particles. So in this case, I'm actually using, let me just show you quickly, the CC particle world effect, which is a 3D aware effect. And I've married the X, Y, and Z position to the null rocket, so it basically controls the motion of it. Now, this is also included with the project files, so you are more than welcome to reverse engineer it and see how I created it if you like to do it. Before I go, I'll quickly walk you through another comp in this project that I'm including in the project files. And this is the text to send. Here you can type whatever you want and it will disintegrate into grain of sand. Feel free to use any font you like. Everything is connected to the other text layers via expressions, so the effects that are applied to them will automatically update. Again, this is based on the same method that I showed you here, using the CC Particle System 2 effect and the Source Alpha Inherence switch. If you need to thicken the effect and add more particles, you can duplicate the Particles 2 layer and change its random seed to get a different variation. You also have instructions on the layer's markers over here. And that's all. I hope this can be useful in your own work. And if it is, please do me a favor, like this video and subscribe to the channel. According to YouTube statistics, 90% of you are watching my videos but still not subscribed. Subscription will help this channel to grow and will allow me to create more content for you. So, thank you for watching, and I will see you again in the next one.